Hi there, I'm John Bond from Riverwinds Consulting, and this is Publishing Defined. Today I'm going to discuss the difference between single-blind and double-blind peer review as it relates to scholarly publishing. As a reminder, peer review is the evaluation of a scholarly article by the editors, editorial board, reviewers of the journal to determine if the article is worthy of publications. Journals may operate under many different types of systems, but single-blind and double-blind peer review are the most common. In single-blind peer review, the authors are not privy to the names of the peer reviewers. In this version, reviewers being anonymous allows for them to be honest in their opinions of the content when giving their feedback to the journal. Authors may be concerned that the reviewer's knowledge of who the author is and the institution may lead to bias in this critique. Single-blind peer review, however, is the most common of all the systems, particularly in STM publishing. In double-blind peer review, both the author and the reviewers are anonymous. The authors take the time to anonymize their article, deleting all references to the author and the institution. Sometimes, however, this anonymizing is done by the journal's editorial staff. In this system, the reviewers are focused on the content and extraneous information, such as the institution or country of origin or how well known the author is, does not interfere in the process. A consideration with double-blind peer review is that, by definition, the reviewers are subject matter experts on the topic of the paper, and they could sometimes take an educated guess as to who the authors are or where the work was done. Aside from single and double blind is the concept of open review. This is when the authors and reviewers know who each other are. On the plus side, it leads to a more transparent process. On the downside, some fear that politeness or political correctness on the reviewer's part may lead to reserved criticism, allowing inferior material to move forward in the publication process. Open review, while practiced by some notable publications, is not widespread at this time. The debate continues whether single-blind or double-blind is the most optimal form of peer review. A quick search of the web will yield several interesting studies about the benefits or disadvantages of either one, as well as a lot of personal commentary. Human nature and a natural bias towards a specific topic or practice will make either single-blind or double-blind potentially flawed. A complete lack of conflict of interest cannot be avoided because the reviewers are people. Whether single or double-blind, the best an author can do is choose a well-respected journal they are familiar with and submit meaningful work that is well-written. After that, it's up to the editor and editorial board to facilitate a meaningful peer review that is free of bias, conflict of interest, or agenda peddling. This includes maintaining a well-respected board of experts that are current in their fields and know what is expected of them to provide quality review. Well, that's it. Hit the like button below if you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel or click on this playlist to see more videos about peer review. And make comments below or email me with any questions. Thanks so much and take care.